This is when real engineering happens. You have to fix the coffee machine.
My name is Sana Söderlund. I am a civil engineer.
This is my day in the life of video.
Civil engineering is problem solving and coming up with ways to resolve how best to service a city or a land development, ways to take care of rainwater, provide water supply and electricity and telecoms, so like internet and phone services to new developments around the city. This here is the Auckland Council maps to look at the zoning for a site, and it allows us to find out things like the site happens to be in a stormwater management area control, so it basically just means that you have to reuse some of the rainwater on site.
We've got quite a few people working from home at the moment, but come on through. We've got a team of about 40 engineers here at Civics, which is pretty cool. Got a lot of grads all the way through to seniors working for us, which we're pretty excited about.
When you first get into engineering, you'll probably be mostly desk-bound doing a lot of design work, but you might also get to go out with some of the more senior engineers.
So we're out here on an earthwork site where we're about to build a road, and so we're just here to inspect the progress and see that everything's going all right on site. This here is going to be a road. So you can see that they've cut the clay, put down some geofabric, and now they're starting to build up the layers that are later going to be a road.
In engineering, generally you'll need an engineering degree, but in saying that, we also have scientists working for us. If you're interested in an engineering degree, I think one of the main things to think about is engineering is more interactive than you might think after going to uni. I used to think it was all about calculations and spreadsheets, but there are a lot of softer values.
So communication and group work is actually really important for what you're going to be doing in your day-to-day.